Hi, you know who I am. I'm the guy that led the team all the way to the Super Bowl. I did not quit, I did not give up, and I told my team members, let's go! When they were discouraged, when we saw the other team winning, we saw that first guy run right down, get a touchdown, second guy ran right down and get a touchdown, down. Another guy intercepted a great pass that I had, and then he took it somewhere else. But you know what? We didn't give up. We kept playing. We won, and we feel really good about that. Same thing happened with that Deflategate thing. I just kept going. I didn't let it bother me, but I stood up for myself because that was wrong. So to have perseverance means you stick with it because you know you're doing the right thing. You know it's going to end up with a win for you, or at least you will feel good about yourself because you stuck with it. I recommend that you try perseverance. I did, and it's working for me. Roger that. Hi, I'm here with Anthony Lombardo from the YMCA Schools Out program. Perseverance is something that means you have to stick with something even though it seems difficult and you feel like quitting. And I just wanted to ask Anthony, because he seems like he's hanging in there, can you give me some examples of perseverance in your life, or tell me how you learned to be that way?
Some types of perseverance are with like sticking to it. So I'm going back into school, so I have to stay, like I'm out of school right now just working, and I have to get ready for this test, so I have to like get into the habit of studying still before the test comes up, and it's hard to do it with work and being at home because I'm out of that element. And then another kind would be, of course, Tom Brady. Yeah. Where how he was a sixth round pick and he was a backup, but he kept working at it, working hard, and look at him now. He's a 5-time Super Bowl champion.
So did your parents help you learn this?
Yes, my parents were a big influence on it. They always told me to work hard and do the best I can. No matter how bad it seems, it all work out in the end.
Yeah, and you always seem to have not a laid back attitude, but a kind of roll with it, go with it, you know, able to deal with whatever the kids throw at you.
Yes.
Attitude.
I definitely do. I take it. I'm easygoing. I have my plan now, for which is what I'm doing right now. And then after I do my tests, I'll worry about what I'm doing next after that. I'll go from there.
Okay, so you persevere until you get your goal, and then you see what the next goal might be.
And then I find a new one next.
Okay, that's good. That's good. I love that. We have Samarin and Ryan here. And they're two of the little guys at the YMCA program. And Samarin, has there ever been something that you've tried to do that you had to stick with it to get it done?
Yeah, like I done this. So when I climb on rocks, sometimes I want to try to give up, but I keep doing it.
Yeah, you keep doing it, even though it seems hard, right? You say, oh, I don't know if I can do this, but I'm going to keep trying.
Yeah, like that's what I do with eating also. Yeah, cause I'm not a very good eater, and I don't like to eat either.
But you know that you should eat because it gives you energy, right? And it's going to make you grow really tall. So even though you think, I really don't want to do this, I'd rather be doing something else, you keep eating, right?
Yeah.
That's a good idea. What's your favorite food?
Me, noodles.
So if it was noodles, you wouldn't have to have perseverance. You would just suck those noodles right in, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, because noodles are good. You love noodles. What's the food that is hard for you to eat and you don't love it so much?
So, I don't, there's hundreds of them.
Hundreds of them. Okay, so, but you have a little bit and then you eat till you know you're full enough, right? Okay, great. Ryan, tell me, what kinds of things have you had to stick with even though it was hard for you?
Like eating and stuff, when my mom makes dinner, I usually wouldn't eat it because I'm not a good eater. But I would eat like a couple stuff.
And so is it because you have something else you want to go do and you don't want to sit down and take that time?
Yeah, I usually want to play at dinner time.
Right, you want to play all the time, I think.
Yeah.
So having to take the time to sit down and eat the food feels like it's taking away from something else you want to do, but you do it because you know it's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you persevere, you stick with it, you eat it till your plate is clean or you had enough, and then you can go do the other thing you were trying to do, right?
Yes.
Yes.
So why do you think it's a good thing to stick with something that you don't like to do, even though, you know, because you'd rather be doing something else? Why is it a good thing to stick with eating even though you don't want to?
Because it gives you energy and it's good for your tummy.
Exactly. So you stick with it because it gives you energy and it's good for your belly and your body, right? Samarn, what did you want to say?
That it's healthy.
It's healthy. So even though you don't want to stick with it, you stick with it because you know it's healthy, right?
Yeah.
Right. All right. So tell the kids in the camera, tell the kids that are going to watch the show, why they should be why they should have perseverance. Why should they stick with something even though they don't love it?
Because it's good for them.
All right, Ryan, how about you? Would you say, why would they stick with something that they don't love?
They could try it, and they could see if they liked it.
Awesome. Thanks very much, guys. I'm here with Kaisha, who is one of the wonderful students at Elmwood School, and has many great character traits. The one we're talking about today is perseverance, which means that she sticks with things, even though they're hard for her to do, but she has great perseverance. So Kaisha, how did you learn to have perseverance? You stick with things until they're done.
Well, I know that if I stick with something, even though it's hard, I'll get some like great things out of it. So even if it's hard to draw something, I will stick with it because once I'm finished, I'll have some beautiful art that we can hang up, and maybe if I grow up, I can become that. Like, I could become an artist if I have good art.
Yes, I'm sure you will grow up to be a great artist in anything you want to be because you know that when you have a goal, you just stick with it because you know there's going to be a reward that comes out of that, even if it's just looking at the great art and saying, wow, that's really great, right?
Yes. And if, like, people see that I made the artwork, it feels really good when they give me compliments, so I like making it. And even though, like, math or something that can be really, really hard when you're doing it, if once you finish, you feel like you've done a very good thing, like doing it, and you feel, and then when you grow up, if I wanted to be a math teacher and teach other people math, I could do it, and I wouldn't know what to do.
So now you see why I asked Kaisha to talk to us about this, because she has really great ideas. So what I'm hearing is, when you do something now, you work really hard at it. First of all, because people say, wow, that's really good. But then, because you look to your future and you say, I might want to be a great artist. I might want to be a math teacher, right?
And when you have, and if you try it first and then you do it, then you can see that you can do that. So you keep working it. But if you just give up, then you'll never know you can do that thing. And so then you won't have a choice. Like, maybe if you didn't know you were good at science, then you might not be able to go up and do really good in school.
Right. So what I'm hearing is you try it and you stick with it, even though you're not sure you're good at it, because you see the value in doing your hardest work and seeing it all the way through. And then in the end, you might say, hey, I'm good at science. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Yes.
So I've heard art, math, and science. Is there anything else that you work really hard at because you think maybe you'll do that in your future? Or do you just do that with everything?
Well, I do it with everything, pretty much, but there might be a few subjects or things that I like to do that I might not that good at, but if I keep trying, I will be able to do it.
Fabulous! Yeah. yes, if you keep trying, you might be able to do it. Exactly right. And that's what perseverance is. You stick with it, even though you're not sure you're good at it. You don't know if you'll ever be a science teacher or a physics professor or an astronomer. But you stick with it because that's you. And that's having great perseverance. And we really appreciate that. We appreciate you, Kaisha. Thank you so much for taking the time. I'm here with Connor, and we're here to talk about perseverance, which means sticking with something even though it's hard for you. And the reason I asked Connor to talk with us is because I know he's into sports, and I know that he works really hard at his studies too. Every time I see him, he's working really hard at something. He laughs and has a good time too, but I could tell he was a hard worker, and that's why I wanted to ask him, do you know what it means to be persevering and stick with something?
Yes, so I was in a basketball game and I stick to the end because you never know what's going to happen. Anything can happen in a game, football, basketball, any sport basically. Even math, reading, something can happen. And that's what I basically did.
Excellent. So in a basketball game, for example, if you're, how many points down? If you're 20 points down, no, you can't be. That's not ever that high. Yeah, you could be 20 points down. Okay, so what would you do if it was 20 points down? What's your position on basketball team?
I would usually be forward, and I was always be wanting to get the ball and try to score. Even if I miss, I don't really care. Just keep at it.
So you would keep trying to throw up the shots? Yeah. And would you try to get more three-point shots, or you would just get any shot you could get?
I would get any shot I could get, but I would usually go for the easy ones.
Okay, good. And so you just keep trying, and hopefully the score would go up.
Yeah, it's basically what I do. Even for football, I'm usually the quarterback, but sometimes get the ball and try to go for a touchdown.
Okay, so you told me that you just finished your basketball season last night, was it?
Yep. And I finished my football season the night before that.
Okay, so what do you do now? Do you take a rest or you start another sport?
Well, not really right now. I'm not doing anything, but usually weekends I have a lot of stuff to do.
So do you train during the time that you're not in a sport, or do you just play and relax and do other things?
I usually go outside and play sometimes, most nights. Then I play a bit of basketball inside my house.
Okay, so you have a basketball court in your house?
No, I have a mini hoop that goes on my door, and I usually use that.
Okay, that's great. So you just keep, so you're practicing accuracy at that point?
Yes.
All right, so sticking with something means that you could possibly win when it looks like you can't win. And in school, what does sticking with something mean if something's hard for you?
Like on a math packet or something, you just keep working at the problem until you possibly get it. And if you can always ask your friend or someone or the teacher to always help you.
Right, but you don't give up and say, oh, I can't do this. I possibly do this.
Yeah, no, I don't do that. I just keep trying to do it. And if I don't get a question, then I'll just skip that question and go on to another one and then come back to it.
That's a great strategy. So what would you say to kids who might be struggling sometimes and they feel like, oh, I can't and I just want to give up?
You can always get a blank sided piece of paper. Just keep practicing it and keep practicing the words or problems that you don't really get. And then you'll get better at them and then they'll be the top ones that you should get.
Awesome. So you're saying that you just keep practicing and you keep trying because you know practice makes perfect or better than nothing. Because if you quit, it's nothing, right?
Yeah, it's basically nothing because you can't really do anything to change the game or your grades or anything like that.
If you quit, right?
Yeah, if you quit. But if you keep trying, something can definitely happen.
All right, thank you so much. If you keep trying, something could definitely happen. I'm here with Matt Clark, who is the on-the-desk person at HCAM Studios, and we're here to talk about perseverance, the character trait of sticking with something until it works. So, Matt, in your life,
And I know we're coming in here a little as a surprise to you. So have there been times when you've almost quit something and you just thought, oh, I can't do this, and you stuck with it?
Oh, absolutely. As a kid, I would try a lot of different things, a lot of sports especially, and I would, you know, go into them excited, and then I would find out in a little ways through that I didn't really like doing this. But the one thing my parents always taught me was, you know, you got to finish out the season. You gotta stick with something. You don't have to keep doing it after this year, but you got to finish out the season. And that's something I've taken with me into adulthood.
That's perfect, because our audience is kids. And so we have kids who probably had the same thing happen to them. Sure. They tried something, they didn't like it, they whined to their parents, and some parents say, okay, that's fine, honey, we don't have to do it anymore. But you're saying that you stuck with it because your parents said you have to finish it.
Yep, like I said, at least for the season with the sports. And if I didn't like it after that, I didn't do it, which was with most of the sports I played. Yeah, that's something they taught me, and it's very important to me now.
Yeah, and that's a great thing for kids to know, is you have to stick with it, because who knows, it may end up that you just needed a little more practice, or you may discover something you didn't know about it that you actually valued. So is there something not sports related that where you didn't know if you'd like it, but you stuck with it, or you didn't think you could do it, but you stuck with it?
Actually, yes. In seventh grade, my friends convinced me to try out for the middle school play with them.
Cool.
And yeah, it was. And I just thought it would be like, oh, this, you know, this is like a goofy thing. I had drama class with the teacher, Miss Gifford, and you know, I liked that. And I was like, oh, you know, this might be a fun thing. But I found out, oh, this is actually a lot of work. And it took up a lot of time, a lot more than I expected, but I stuck with it, and honestly, I've been acting for 10 years now, so.
Wow, that's so awesome. Yeah. So there's a case where you said, I don't know, I'll try, and you stuck with it, and you found out that you love it. So what play was the first play?
The play was called The Princess Plays, okay. And it was a collection of three short plays. I'll be honest, I don't really remember much of them at this point, but it was a lot more fun than I thought it would be, despite how much hard work it was.
Okay, and were you the prince or the frog, or what part do you remember?
I believe I was a farmhand, okay. Actually, in the play, and throughout my years, I did it for the last 2 years of middle school, throughout high school, and actually throughout college as well, and. One of the hardest things for me was I always wanted the lead. Uh-huh. I craved the spotlight, but I was never getting them. Mm-hmm. And it was actually very disheartening. But regardless of that, I stuck with it because it was still fun. And then finally, in my junior year of high school, I finally got the lead that I had craved for so long. And it was an amazing experience.
So persistence pays off. And what was the lead and what was the play?
The lead was the role of the Pharaoh in Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat.
Gosh.
Yeah, the high school's 2010 fall musical. That was an incredible show. I met a lot of my best friends doing that show. It was an amazing experience.
That's great. So what I'm hearing is, when you stick with something, sometimes you find out something that you really love, and if you don't find out something that you really love, you learn that sticking with something is the right way to go, even if it's for the short term, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep. You'll never lose anything sticking with something, that's for sure.
Thank you so much. That's great. Hey, Ready Freddy.
What, Piggy Wiggy?
You know what I heard?
What'd you hear?
I heard a story about a guy named Edwin T. Barnes, I think, who owned a mining company, and they dug and they dug and they dug and they got some gold and they got more gold, and then they couldn't get any more gold.
What? There was no more gold in the gold mine?
Yeah. So he sold his vehicles and all his digging equipment to another guy, and then he quit and he went to do another job. I think he ran insurance companies or something.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and so the other guy called in an expert.
He called in like an engineer or somebody, and this somebody looked at the ground, looked at the rocks, and decided to move the digging 3 feet over.
Yeah, and what happened then?
Well, guess what?
What?
They found tons of gold, and they dug, and they got all kinds of money because they moved that digger over 3 feet.
Oh my goodness, you mean if the first guy had stuck with it, he would have found more gold?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. But he quit. He thought he couldn't get any more. And you know what? The other guy called an expert. So the lesson is,
yeah,
stick with something. And if you run into a roadblock, call an expert, ask a teacher, get some help, but don't quit.
Right, that makes sense. So if he didn't quit, he would have been so rich.
That's right. But he actually learned from his lesson. So he ended up being rich in the insurance business or something else, I forget.
Oh, that's great. Thank you so much for telling me about that. Now I'm not going to quit next time.
Yeah, that's a good idea, Ready Freddy. What? So what did we learn today? What did we learn? We learned stick with it and you get rewarded. We learned keep trying and you get better. We learned practice makes perfect. And we all know that if you stick with something and you believe that you can get that goal, a lot of times you do get that goal. Again, look at what happened in our last Super Bowl. We went into overtime because we didn't quit. We didn't give up. James White ran for that touchdown. He put that ball over the end. Goal! Touchdown! So you gotta stick with it in order to make it a success. You can't quit when you're halfway, even though the other team is up by 23 points or whatever it was. I wasn't counting. I wasn't looking at the score. I was just concentrating on winning. You got to stick with it. That's perseverance. Why do we do this? Because perseverance is part of having a good character, and character matters. Hey, Edelman, go out for a pass, buddy. So why is persevering a good character trait? As you will see in the interviews and quotes, sticking with something means you are more likely to reach your goal, and if you get there, you know you gave it everything you had and you succeeded. Napoleon Bonaparte was one of the world's greatest military leaders and became the first emperor of France after leading his armies to success in the French Revolution. Napoleon is quoted as saying, "Victory belongs to the persevering." Our character, Tom Brady, is like a general on the field. His great character, as well as the guidance of coaches and owners, has made the Patriots a team who keep going when the going gets tough. The Pats didn't let the first or second quarter success of the Atlanta Falcons deflate their hopes. They persevered until the end, and they won. Go Pats! Anthony, our YMCA worker, spoke to us of working toward his college degree while working at the Y, which takes perseverance. He described how he sets a goal and works toward that goal. Then when he gets there, he is open to what the next goal will be. That way, he is focused on the task at hand and doesn't let things distract him. He is open to future possibilities, but not while he is persevering in his plan. Our students, Samayan and Ryan, agreed that perseverance is needed when eating their food. Samayan loves noodles, but finds it hard to eat other food. He knows that it is good for him and that his parents want him to eat, so he perseveres and eats his food. Ryan finds it hard to eat his food because eating interrupts what he really wants to do, which is play. He knows that the food is good for him, so he eats for his belly, but would rather be doing other things. Both of these boys persevere in doing something that is hard. That shows good character. Kaisha likes doing well in school for the approval of her teacher, her parents, and because she enjoys the subjects, but she also has long-term goals. Kaisha mentioned enjoying math, art, and science as subjects now, but they might be future careers. I am sure Kaisha will be successful at whatever goal she perseveres towards. Connor, our young sports star, spoke of sticking with something because it might work out, and if you don't stick with it, you have nothing. Connor gives his athletic efforts his all, whether it's football, basketball, or just playing Newcomb at recess. Connor also works hard at his studies, doing his best and sticking with it until he is done. He is what's called a student athlete. I am sure that if he gives a game his all and loses anyway, that is hard for him. But he knows he did his best and the score didn't reflect his efforts, so he is still a winner. Our puppets, Ready Freddy and Piggy Wiggy, told us a story of a real person, Edmund Barnes, who was a gold miner and quit mining when it seemed like the gold ran out. But he was just 3 feet from hitting another vein of gold. He sold his mining equipment and went to work in insurance. The person who bought his machines called in an expert and found the new gold vein, then made millions. Edmund Barnes learned his lesson and went on to being successful in selling insurance because he didn't give up on his sales. Matt, who works at HCAM now, spoke of being in plays throughout his middle and high school years. He had expectations of being the star, but didn't achieve that until his junior year at Hopkinton High School in Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. Matt said, "You can never lose if you stick with something." Matt and Connor both know that if you give something half-hearted effort, you have already lost. So why bother to stick with something difficult or which is not your favorite thing? As all of our interviews and quotes describe, giving something a full effort will always mean you succeed, even if the role or the score doesn't reflect your effort. The alternative, doing something halfway or quitting, leaves you with nothing. If you did everything you could, you are a winner. Persevering is part of having a good character, and character matters.